Thank you, Paul.
Thanks, Ryan. How many people are first time here? We've got a few. Thanks for coming. I thought maybe I'd just give about a minute and a half explanation of the instrument. The number one question that I get is, why an organ in a warehouse? And then the short answer is, because we can. When this building we're in now is about 20 years old, and our factory is about 6 blocks that way, we ran out of space. So we put the first 20,000 square feet here, and we thought that would last about 5 years, but we outgrew it in 18 months. So the decision was, do we add on to the building or buy another building? So we looked at another building, and my dad was still alive, and he was talking about the age of the roof and the parking and the layout, and I thought, gee, this is 3-second echo in here, I could do something with that. So I hatched the idea of an organ. So Jelani Eddington is the colorist who really designed the what it sounds like. It's based on the Wanamaker organ in Philadelphia. And it is being built by the Century Organ out of Minneapolis. And it's, we're about 18 years into the project. We're almost done. It has a half-life like plutonium. So, but it's a full symphonic instrument. It is designed to be a full orchestra to fingertips as well as about 6,500 pipes. So, thanks for coming. We it's built to be shared. We do doors open to Milwaukee. We do, because the DTO is Milwaukee, we do about 4 free concerts here, 3 or 4. And we appreciate you coming.
Thanks again. Like I said, DTOS is interested in promoting these instruments, so about every month we have a different program we put on. Some are in big venues like this, some in theaters, and believe it or not, some people even have these, albeit a little smaller, in their homes. And so we do those types of programs. If you're interested in membership, Neil, Wave, or really any of us in the red shirts or in the back, you can learn more about membership. Lastly, before we introduce our guest organist today, I want to introduce Mike Jacklin, who serves as our, whatever we call you, technical person. But we are doing a very large restoration of the theater pipe organ in a theater in downtown Lake Geneva. So we just wanted to give you a small update on that.
And as I'm doing that, I'm going to ask everybody who's here for the first time to hold your hand up again. We got some gals that are going to come around and give you some business cards. It's got our website on it. No. It's got our website on it, and there's a QR code on the back so that you can find out more about what we as an organization do. I've been a member now 5 years, 6 months in. I was approached and asked to become the project coordinator for the club, keeping things running, ordering the materials, helping people get involved and all that. Well, the first project I jumped in on was the biggest one that we were doing, because this is a 100% restoration of a 10 rank, meaning 10 sets of pipes and bunches of toys like you see out here that is presently being installed now in the theater in Lake Geneva. The update on that, for those of you who are members, the shelf has been built. All the percussions are now in the solo chamber. They are half winded, half wired. The main solo chest is now in the chamber, and that's going to have its winding start this week, and the rest of that wiring will be happening. We are hoping to be at a point of where I can say we can turn on the wind when we've got the blower connected by the end of December, because I'd really love to see that blower turn on before I go in for knee replacement surgery. No, it didn't happen. It's working on the crew. It's just something that's it. So, part of the reason we do this is to preserve these instruments. These are historical instruments. The one we are working on will be celebrating its 100th anniversary of coming out of the factory this coming year in 2025. And Ryan didn't say it, we're hosting the National American Theater Organ Society Convention here in Wisconsin, meaning a whole week of nothing but listening to these kind of instruments all across the state. So if you're interested, check out the website, you can join us, and then you can join and become a part of the convention. It's something that's bigger than what we are. Thank you.
Okay. Our guest organist today comes to us all the way from Detroit. started playing piano at age 3, organ at 12, and then stumbled on the theater pipe organ at 16. Serves as a house organist at the Fox Theater in Detroit, also the organist for the Detroit Red Wings hockey games and Detroit Tigers baseball. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Dave Calendine. Stiff, and when I heard a theater organ, I said I immediately have to get my hand. on that. So I actually ended up driving. I had just gotten my driver's license, so I was able to go hear a concert at the Akron Civic Theater with an artist by the name of Lynn Larson, and I just fell in love with the organ. So then I drove back to the theater by telling my parents I was going to hang out at the mall with all my friends, but I drove an hour to Akron to say, can I play the organ? And they looked at me and said, yeah, right, kid, go away. And so I went back again on Tuesday, on Wednesday, on Thursday, they threatened to call the police on me. And on Friday, they were about to call the police, but then they said, we have a movie tonight, and we just had two people call off. If you pop popcorn and sell popcorn and clean up at the end of the night, we'll let you play the organ after the show. And they came and said, this is the cleanest we've ever seen the stand. This is great. And they let me play the organ. So I ran down and was just amazed that, wow, you hit the xylophone, it plays the xylophone. You hit the tambourine, it plays the tambourine. And so I was just goofing around with the organ like that, trying to figure out how everything worked. And then they finally said, well, for crying out loud, play something. And then it's just like, what am I going to play? And then I realized I have a little music box at home that has a little birdie in it. And if you turn it on, it plays the song Yellow Bird, because it's a little yellow bird and the bird bounces around. So here, several years later, is the very first song I ever played on a theater organ. Here's Yellow Bird.
Thank you.
driving to Anchorage. So at the end of the day, I would go to my friend's house and say, what did you do at the mall? Okay, so that when I got home, I could tell my parents. And then since they talked to each other's parents, they would all go, oh, okay. When I got done playing at the theater that day, they had me write my name and phone number on a piece of paper. Well, the only paper that I found was on the floor of the orchestra pit, and it was two ticket stubs. So I wrote my name and my phone number. Turned out that the two ticket stubs, my name was on one half, my number was on the other. They somehow lost the name and just had the number. So while I was at school the one day, the general manager called and said, yeah, we'd like to talk to the young man that's been driving to the Akron Civic Theater every day last week to play the organ. And it's just like, nobody here. He says, no, his name's, I believe, Dave. He plays the organ. And so, needless to say, my parents didn't know what to do because my mom was mad, my dad was mad, but then here I was being offered a job. So they didn't know whether to yell at me or think. So I got a little bit of both, but it was still a little fun way to get started with the organ world. Today I'm now I'm the former chairman of the American Theater Organ Society. I'm now the current treasurer. I've been helping as much as I can with the preparations for the convention here, and I tell you, this chapter is one of the best chapters out there as far as organization and getting everything done. If you're not a part of this chapter, I can't encourage you enough to become a member of DTOS to be able to share all the different wonderful instruments that they have here, but then also to be a part of the convention is going to be really special, and I'm really looking forward to coming to the convention this year. So a big props to the Dairyland Theater Organ Society for all they're doing to keep in these wonderful instruments going. So let's give them a round of applause. I just realized I forgot my list of music on the side, so I was like, oh, what am I going to play next? I forgot. We're going to have fun with a little bit of a polka. Not the standard polka that you're probably thinking of, but I'll play those later, don't worry. Here is a polka, more of a classical one, a fun little one called Trish Trash Polka. is a shared passion with steam trains. And I have, for the past several years, been able to do a large benefit event at the San Filippo Estate, which is a large estate in Barrington Hills, West Chicago, and do a benefit fundraiser for the Illinois Railway Museum Steam Department. Matter of fact, I'll be in town doing that next Sunday. And one of the things that my brother and I have been able to accomplish by doing this benefit with all the raffles and all the extra train stuff is we've been able to pay for the full restoration of two steam locomotives. So the two steam locomotives that are running at the Illinois Railway Museum is because of a theater organ. And so but one of the fun things that I do, well, thank you, thank you. And next Sunday is actually our 13th, should have been 15, but you know, that whole COVID thing. So, but this will be our 13th year of doing that next Sunday. And but one of the fun things of doing that is you can take all of this craziness and make it sound like a steam train is about to come through. So we're going to have some fun because I'm going to play a little bit of some songs of the choo-choo. And so here's some railroad songs.
Thank you.
Thanksgiving coming up, I'm going to use this next piece to highlight the classical side. Up behind me on top, where you see the chimes, is a very large classical division of this organ as well. And there's a piece that was arranged by Virgil Fox, a very prominent organist in the classical organ world, and one of my favorites to play this time of year. So here's an arrangement of Now Thank We All Our God. Thank you. cartridge just fit these organs so nicely, so you'll hear another one by the time I'm done. But we're now going to journey back to my church organ days. I'm not home enough to have a regular church job, but when I am at my church, I do get to enjoy playing. But there's some wonderful hymns, both old, mainly the older ones. I'm not a fan of this new stuff that they do with all the guitars and all that, but you know, it's each their own. But I love some of the older hymns, but I'm going to sort of theatricalize them some, if you will. So here's some of my favorite hymns, starting with Whispering Hope. How many of you remember that old one? And then we'll go to What a Friend We Have in Jesus, How Great Thou Art, and then I'll end with Amazing Grace. So here's how I would love to be able to do some of the hymns on Sunday morning. I am Presbyterian. We are known as the Frozen Chosen, so sometimes I do have to behave. But anyway, this is what I would love to do on Sunday mornings.
Thank you.
while I'm in town, and for Toby for babysitting the organ for me while I was getting everything set up. And then all of you for coming out and spending time here on a Sunday afternoon. I'd love to meet you. I'm going to remain up here at the console. If you have any questions and want to come up and see things, by all means come up. I can answer any questions. And I'm also really good at making up answers if I don't know them. So come on up and ask me anything. You'll get something out of me. But you know, if you go to the store, it's already set up for Christmas, so I would be amiss if I didn't at least play one Christmas song. So I'm going to end with probably the most famous Christmas song that was written for the Boston Pops Orchestra. So here is Leroy Anderson's Sleigh Ride. And with that, I will say thank you so much. I look forward to seeing you again in the future.